Meanwhile, breaking news coming in. French police have reportedly launched an investigation into disappearance of Interpol's president. And a Chinese government minister was reported missing after traveling to his native country last week. The 64-year-old lives in the French city of Lyon with his wife and children, who have not heard from him since he left for China on 29th of last month. Meng was elected president of Interpol, which helps global police forces cooperate on investigations. In November 2016, he is also China's deputy minister of public security and has previously served as head of country's counter-terrorism office, drugs control commission and coast guard. His term as Interpol's chief is due to run until 2020. So breaking news coming in, Interpol chief was visiting his native. And we are joined by my colleague Palki Sharma Upadhyay for more on this. Palki, what's latest on this?
Well, we don't know very little. As you said, the French police have launched an investigation. The man in question is a Chinese minister. And when he was elected as the Interpol chief in November 2016, that was a controversial decision because many said, including Amnesty International and Human Rights Watch, that he will be used by the Chinese government to track Chinese dissidents abroad. As it turns out, he himself has gone missing. His wife and children live in the southern French city of Lyon, and they've been trying to get in touch with him. He landed in China, we understand, on the 29th of September. It's been almost a week. They've not been able to establish any sort of contact with him. So we do not know for sure what has become of this man. And it's ironic, Sumit, because the world, including agencies in India, rely on the Interpol to track and arrest criminals or people who have charges against them. And the Interpol chief himself goes missing, and that casts more than a shadow on the agency, the international agency that is meant to help police in various countries coordinate and track the movements of such individuals. The man in question, as you said, is Meng Hongwei, and he is 64 years old, and he has been living in France for the past 2 years. His term would have expired in 2020, and we've not heard from the Chinese agencies. We can tell you that the French police have spoken to Reuters and a radio station, Europe One, saying that Mr. Meng's family has not been able to get in touch with him. He's China's deputy minister of public security.
Well, definitely, Palki. Any other things we know about the circumstances surrounding his disappearance and any word from Chinese authorities as he was traveling to China while he got disappeared?
It's very hard to elicit any information out of the Chinese authorities. They haven't spoken yet, and this report has just come out by way of Associated Press and some of these agents in the French police speaking to Reuters and Europe One. So it's still early days, and we do not have very many details of what has happened. The Chinese government, I can tell you, has not spoken about this, but I'm sure if they wanted to cooperate, it would be easy to find this man. As an idea, it is shocking, Sumit, that the chief of Interpol goes missing and his family and his agency is not able to establish contact with him. And that is a bigger mystery, is a bigger story, I believe, than the fact that this man is, I'm sure they'll be able to establish contact with him sooner rather than later. But the fact is, for a person in his position to go missing for 6 days and for governments to not respond to such a serious report is alarming, to say the least.
Well, also, Palki, earlier reports said that Amnesty International and Human Rights Watchdog voiced fears that China could look to exploit his position to pursue dissidents abroad. So any other thing we know about, like what else could be the reason or what could be the reason? Anything? Any word on that?
I cannot say for sure if he was involved in any case that had Chinese nationals or that had the involvement of the Chinese government, but the record of the Chinese government is for the world to see, and they've been known to crack down very hard on dissidents both at home and abroad. And these concerns were voiced that he may be used, as I understand it, and this is pure speculation, I want to say, that if he has gone missing in China, there's a possibility that he did not cooperate with the Chinese authorities, but we do not have anything to base this on. So this is just pure conjecture, but this is how I understand things could have gone for a person to go missing in China. It would help immensely if the Chinese government came out with their version or told the world when he landed, where he went. We've also not heard from his family in China, and his family in Lyon, understandably in France, is keeping it quiet because they do not want want to jeopardize the situation, Sumit.
And any word coming from Interpol on this? As we understand, French police has launched an investigation into the whole incident. But any word coming from Interpol on this as well?
Interpol, of course, is working with the French authorities because Mr. Meng lived in France, and the judicial department in France is involved in this investigation, as they put it, and they're trying to get in touch. So, as I understand, the sequence of events could be this. 29th of September, he went to China to try and get in touch with his family there. His family in Lyon could not establish contact with him. They must have tried for a few days. Then they reached out to the agency, which in turn would have told the French authorities and other European authorities to try and find out what happened. But the bigger shocker here is the fact that this is the chief of the Interpol, the very agency that the world relies on to find dissidents, to find people who have been caught on the wrong side of the law. And that is what is more shocking, Sumit, in this story.
Well, absolutely, Palki. And do you expect other countries to join the probe as well? Because, again, Interpol, as we all know, that is a multinational organization. And other countries, is there any possibility could join the probe in case the overall disappearance, nobody is able to find him anytime soon?
I'm assuming Interpol will use all the resources at its disposal to find its chief. If they can't do that, what good are they for? So Interpol is going to use agencies and individuals in various countries. But remember, he was last seen in China. So it would help if Chinese authorities help, because police in any other country will not be able to weigh in or help out if the man is still in China. We do not know his whereabouts, and that is the key to this entire situation.
And for the benefit of our viewers, Palki, can you help outline the role of Interpol, what role it plays, what kind of importance it has in the present scenario?
Well, Interpol is an inter-country agency that helps police in various nations to coordinate. They share intelligence, they share data, they share the whereabouts of individuals. If somebody is wanted in India and there's been an Interpol red corner notice against that particular individual, then agencies across the world are alerted that this is a man or a woman on the run and has to be caught. And wherever that person is found, eventually the extradition treaties or whatever treaties come into effect are explored, and that individual is brought back to his or her home country where he or she is accused of having committed any crime. This is how Interpol operates. It's basically an agency that helps in coordinating cases of crime and investigation. And this story has particularly made it to the headlines because of the fact that the chief of such an agency himself has gone missing, Sumit.
Well, absolutely, it's shocking because this agency, in a way, probes and even sometimes apprehends and arrests people at various airports, and the chief of such agency himself is missing. But overall, can you draw a parallel with some other incidents like this that have taken place, and the chief of certain investigative agencies that have got disappeared? Do we know of any other agencies, like a chief of agencies like this, who have got disappeared like this?
Off the top of my head, I wouldn't be able to come up with a parallel, Sumit. And they're not calling it a disappearance yet. They're saying that he's not. They've not been able to contact with him. The Interpol chief has gone missing. So, well, you could say that this is just semantics. But I think the investigators are still hopeful, and they hope to get some sort of cooperation from the Chinese agencies to ensure that they find this person as soon as possible. Today is what, the 5th of October. So it's been almost a week since they last got in touch with him. His family last spoke to him when he landed in China. And we do not know the details as to which Chinese city he went to, how big a family he has in China. Remember, he's also a minister in the Chinese government. And that's something that's very, very important. If at all Chinese agencies are involved, it'll be a big deal that they have acted against their own minister and a man who is heading an agency like the Interpol.
So you mean to say that there is a possibility that Chinese agencies could be involved in the disappearance, or it'll be too early to arrive at any kind of conclusion, or it'll be a big speculation as well?
I wouldn't go as far as saying that the Chinese government may be involved. I do not know the details of the matter as to where he went and what his situation is. Remember, this is also a man who's 64 years old. I do not know what his health is like right now. So I will not go so far as to speculate that the Chinese agencies may have had a hand. But this is, as we said, a matter of investigation, a subject of investigation. And the French agencies, the French police, are on the lookout.
All right, Palki, thanks for joining us and getting us all these details for the benefit of our viewers. We must tell them once again, the French police have reportedly launched an investigation into disappearance of Interpol's president, a Chinese government official. And that's our breaking news coming in. There is no, so far, conclusion of what has happened to him.